Have you been thinking learning happens in school, not sleep? One of the most common questions I get when talking about wake up and learn or sleep in general, especially with school districts and parents, is why should school worry about sleep? Well, the truth is sleep is a critical component to learning and memory. When we think about the learning process, we typically think about it in three phases: acquisition, consolidation, and retrieval. Acquisition is the process of gaining new information or experience, kind of like what you're doing now, acquiring new information about sleep and learning. Retrieval is the ability to bring that new information back to be able to use it, such as when you are taking a test or when I email you next week asking you what you learned today. I'm just kidding. Consolidation of learning, or making this new information a concrete part of your memory, well, that occurs during sleep. There are multiple theories of how exactly this occurs, and they mainly center on that it's a process where either there is a reinforcement of these new connections or neuronal interactions that occurs and strengthens the memory, or that is a pruning or removal process of non-helpful connections. The truth probably resides somewhere in the middle, with current evidence suggesting that probably both processes are at play. However, the relationship between sleep and learning doesn't stop there. There is mounting evidence to show different contributions based on which stage of sleep we are talking about. For instance, non-REM, and most typically non-REM 2 sleep, has the suggestion of being very influential in what is called declarative learning. This is the typical school-related learning, like 1 + 1 = 2, I can declare to you how I reasoned that out and came to that answer. On the other hand, there has been a suggestion that REM sleep may be critical for non-declarative learning, like I learned how to dribble a basketball by repeated activity, not because I was instructed to move my hand in a specific angle and a velocity to do so. That might make sense that babies and younger kids have so much REM sleep then. Not convinced that sleep is relevant to reinforcing your learning? Well, let's look at it from the other direction. Let's disturb sleep and see if there's a consequence. Impaired sleep can reduce ability to maintain attention, reduce impulse control, so you'll be less likely to suppress the immediate selection of an incorrect response. An impaired working memory, or the ability to reason through or clearly process thoughts or multitask. In fact, when studied, students with impaired sleep tend to have lower GPAs and standardized test performance that actually improved when the sleep was optimized. So, long story short, don't shortchange yourself. Take advantage of sleep as a tool for academic success. And if you're struggling to do so, take a closer look at what you can do better. Understand why using a sleep diary to track your patterns, one of the sleep screeners to help see if you have a sleep problem. Always discuss with your doctor if you have concerns. Is studying for finals keeping you up all night? This is a time where many students feel they have no other option than cram sessions or feeling underprepared. If they don't pull an all-nighter before an exam, well, what are some better options to consider? First, consider the possibility of sleep banking. Just like you can have too little sleep and create sleep debt, strategically elongating your sleep before an expected period of deprivation can be called sleep banking. This has the possibility of helping reduce the negative impact of that all-nighter. An alternative strategy that may have two benefits include breaking up the all-nighter with naps. This will help you get at least some sleep that night before the big test, but may also have the added benefit of helping to facilitate some of that consolidation of the learning you're trying to cram in. Obviously, the goal should always be trying to get the best night's sleep, but I'm realistic, and sometimes other temporary strategies may be needed.